Washington Times opinion editor, Charlie Hurt, coming to us tonight, by the way, from Liberty University. I'm double-checking the record here, 2-0, the first in the Big South. And President Falwell told me last year that they're going to surprise folks, and indeed they are.
Yeah, it's truly amazing. And this is their first year in the conference, and it's a tremendous thing.
Well, I'm sorry to start with football, but I just found that fascinating. and President Falwell backing up his, if you will, brag on the field of play, or at least with some very good young men who are backing him up.
You should see the campus, too. I mean, what they've done down here is just absolutely amazing. It's really, truly gorgeous what they've put into this place over the last 10 years.
And it's great to see the success of the university. It's truly. Yeah. Let's turn to the Dems and the president coming up with these late dinner session mind melds, apparently, of some sort. But with Chuck Schumer coming out of the White House to announce the grand bargain of all time, and people running with it before the White House could even react. It is your reaction to it all?
Well, you know, anybody that finds any of this surprising obviously has not been paying attention to the first part of this administration or for the campaign over the past 2 years. This is exactly the way Donald Trump operates. And he has worked tirelessly, although hopelessly, with Republicans to get things done with them. And not only get things done that he had promised in his campaign, but all of them had promised in their campaigns. And so the idea that he's turning around now, negotiating with the Democrats, it's a smart move. It's not, you know, as a conservative, it's not what I would rather him figure out a way to strike a deal with Republicans, because that would be a more conservative deal. But I mean, you can't blame the guy for doing this.
In the social media firestorm that did follow. It is also difficult to understand why the president, who ended DACA once, because, of course, it belongs in Congress as a matter of constitutional parameter, and yet he wants to be involved in it again, in bargaining, discussing, negotiating, agreeing, whatever he did with Schumer and Pelosi. I mean, it's just, it's very odd to many people that he would then sort of re-inject himself into DACA.
Yeah, but I think that he views that as being something of a bargaining chip, and as he does the wall, and if he can sort of, you know, hey, look, the guy's not a partisan guy. He's not a conservative. He's certainly not a liberal, but he's a practical guy.
Well,
he's a pragmatic guy.
And I think Charlie, he does say he is conservative. That he is a conservative.
Yeah, but he's not conservative in the sort of Washington sense, which I don't think
hasn't been very successful. He's not in the Paul Ryan sense at all.
And you know, he made this deal with the Democrats on the debt ceiling that they call it around here.
Right.
We've had that debt ceiling around here for what, 25 years. And do you know how much the debt has gone up since they put the debt ceiling on? It's gone up.
And did you listen to the morons try to defend the debt ceiling? Oh, no, we can't lose the debt ceiling. What would we have to shut the government down? And would we really have to pay our bills? You know, these are some of the most confused, conflicted people we could ever put in elected office, the leadership in the House and Senate.
And I think that that's exactly why voters sent somebody like Donald Trump, is because, you know, he may not have even known what a debt ceiling was before he got here, but at least he's going to do something different, because we know what the outcome is going to be with these people. After 25 years of the debt ceiling, it's gone up, what, $16 trillion or $15 trillion. And people just want something to change.
Yeah, something to change. And they do want the damn wall built. Let's leave that.
Yes,
the base wants that wall built. It's not symbolic.
And they don't like amnesty.
I won't even say that word. I don't want to. I'm touching that word. Charlie Hurt, thanks for being with us. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Lou.